Welcome to this month's edition of the Microsoft 365 Update. In the next few minutes, I'll be giving you a quick rundown of the latest new features and enhancements with a goal of helping you get the most out of the service. Microsoft believes accessibility and inclusion are essential to delivering on our mission to empower every person and organization on the planet to achieve more. Recently announced enhancements to PowerPoint address some of the different ways in which some of us experience presentations. Live captions and subtitles, powered by artificial intelligence, or AI, promise to make them better understood by more people. When this feature is available, you'll click on Slideshow, then Subtitle Settings. You'll see the options for the speaker's language, the subtitle language, and where you'd like the content to appear. The deaf or hard of hearing can benefit from the ability to read what's being spoken in real time. And those not fluent in the presenter's language can see a real-time translation of the presentation in their language.
Bring your presentations to life with 3D. Getting started with 3D in PowerPoint. Why use 3D? 2D slides are a static portrait. The audience is passive and cannot interact. 3D helps foster conceptual understanding and visual and spatial thinking. Animated 3D models display objects within space in ways text and images cannot.
Live captions and subtitles in PowerPoint will begin rolling out in late January 2019 and will be available for Office 365 and Microsoft 365 subscribers worldwide for PowerPoint on Windows, PowerPoint for Mac, and PowerPoint Online. I sometimes like to say you need an MBA, you know, a master's in buzzwords and acronyms, to work at a company like Microsoft because we have a language all our own. In my group, we use an acronym known as FRI, which stands for Field Readiness Index, and another known as RIS, which is short for Readiness Impact Score. My guess is that your industry, organization, and even your department has its own terms that are a mystery to those not in the know. Microsoft AI leverages the Microsoft Graph to make suggestions for acronyms specific to your group, making documents easier to understand. Options for creating presentations without starting from scratch continue to improve. PowerPoint has always had an incredible number of templates to choose from. As a matter of fact, I frequently leverage these templates when creating content for this video series. To see what's available, click on New and type in Search, or select one of the suggested searches, and you can find professional-looking templates. Truth be told, that I found some interesting ones preparing for this segment that I didn't even know were there, like these Office Tips infographic templates. Of course, you and your organization can create your own templates as well. But in all honesty, the workflow I most frequently find myself following, and maybe you do too, is that of taking an existing deck I or one of my colleagues already created and using that as a starting point for a new presentation. That's where the newer reuse slide capability can be quite helpful. Simply click the Reuse Slides button in the Home tab to surface existing PowerPoint presentations in the sidebar and browse through recommended PowerPoint decks you have access to. View the slides in the presentation you'd like to borrow from, select the ones you want, and insert them into your deck. If the AI doesn't suggest the right presentation, you can conduct a search to find the one you want. We're encouraged to leverage the great work of others here at Microsoft, and this slide reuse feature streamlines that process. Dark themes in operating systems and applications are gaining popularity. Many users prefer darker themes because they are easier on the eyes, especially under low lighting conditions. Others, like me, like them because they look pretty cool. Microsoft introduced the ability to choose a default app mode setting of light or dark in Windows 10 a while back and extended that functionality to the Windows File Explorer, starting with the October 2018 update, also known as Build 1809. In case you didn't know, dark gray and black themes have been available for some time for the Office desktop apps on Windows. One way to configure them is by clicking on File, then Options, then selecting the desired theme in the General tab of any Office app. With the release of macOS Mojave, Mac users can also add a darker appearance to their desktop. Now, Microsoft Office for Mac inherits the appearance settings from the operating system. On macOS, click on System Preferences, then General. If you select the dark option under Appearance, those settings will flow through to Office for Mac. Be sure to give these dark mode settings a try to see if they work for you. The two things I'm almost never without are my wallet and my smartphone. Since our phones are one thing many of us always have with us, it's critically important for Microsoft to optimize the experience of using Office apps on those devices. In fact, so many of us are interested in achieving more on the go that our Office apps for Android and iOS have been downloaded more than 100 million times. As our mobile apps innovation continues, iOS users will be the first to see improvements using these core mobile-first design principles. First, deliver uncompromised craftsmanship and attention to detail. Second, create fast and focused experiences. And third, provide key context at a glance. The craftsmanship and attention to detail principle manifests itself in the sensory feedback you'll experience with the device cradled in your hand. You may also notice subtle cues like changes in color, shape, and iconography as you interact with emails. On the fast and focus front, users will also notice a new app header with bold color and typography that makes apps easier to identify as you switch between them. However, once you're in the app, the header size and iconography are dynamically reduced so you can focus on the content rather than the Chrome. Finally, regarding contextual relevance, those with multiple accounts will see cues to help you switch between them. And bright and bold headers added to your contacts so you can identify them more easily when searching or inviting them to meetings. Outlook Mobile delivers a powerful experience that helps you achieve your goals and save you time so you can get back to what matters most in your day. The best way to see these innovations as soon as they're released is to join the Office Insiders program. Microsoft Bookings allows the customers of an organization to book appointments. While some obvious examples include a business like a dentist's office, dog grooming service, or perhaps a barbershop, Bookings is being used in businesses of all sizes. I'm happy to report that Bookings is getting even better. The improvements lie in the areas of enterprise-grade controls, customization, integration, and the Bookings mobile app. While the blog article I linked to in the resources guide provides more detail on each of these capabilities and the timing of their release, I'd like to cover one I'm looking forward to. That's leveraging Bookings for internal use in the organization. When this option is configured, users will need to authenticate with their Office 365 work or school account before they are able to access and use a Bookings page. We have an internal on-site PC support group here at Microsoft that something like this would be perfect for. And I've also urged the team I schedule these recordings with to check it out. While I knew Bookings was available as part of Office 365 Business Premium and Microsoft 365 Business Plans, I also learned that administrators can enable Bookings for enterprise customers with the Office 365 or Microsoft 365 E3 and E5 plans. Some of us no longer need to dream of a world without passwords. We're living in it. Well, my world isn't completely without passwords, but I no longer use one when signing into my Windows PC. Instead, I use Windows Hello for Business, which replaces passwords with strong two-factor authentication on PCs and mobile devices. Modern multi-factor authentication, or MFA technologies, like the biometrics and public key cryptography in Windows 10 PCs and popular mobile phones, is one of the most meaningful actions organizations can take to mitigate their identity risk. Microsoft is committed to enabling a world without passwords, and organizations can prepare themselves by developing a plan to transition to these passwordless technologies. I've linked to more information in the Transcript and Resources Guide, which includes a white paper titled Passwordless Protection: Reduce Your Risk Exposure with Password Alternatives. Be sure to check it out. That's it for this month. As always, you can download the Transcript and Resources Guide that accompanies this video at the URL you see on the screen. I'm Jim Narosky. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon.